In a world-changing breakthrough, Microsoft researchers have integrated OpenAI's ChatGPT with robotics, enabling the use of natural language to control various devices, including drones, robot arms, home assistant robots, and more. This breakthrough finally allows humans to easily communicate their intentions to robots just like they would to another human, bridging the gap between man and machine. The team behind this research aims to create a more intuitive human-robot interaction without relying heavily on handwritten code. ChatGPT is a language model that has been trained on a vast corpus of text and human interactions, allowing it to generate coherent and grammatically correct responses to a variety of prompts and questions. But now, the AI researchers have granted ChatGPT access to features that control a physical drone, and the results were impressive, with the AI model acting as an intuitive language-based interface between the non-technical user and the robot. ChatGPT asked for further clarification when the user's instructions were ambiguous and composed intricate code structures for the drone, such as a zigzag pattern to inspect shelves visually. It even figured out how to take a selfie. Moreover, in a simulated industrial inspection scenario using the Microsoft AirSim simulator, the researchers used ChatGPT to efficiently and precisely control the drone by interpreting the user's high-level intentions and geometrical cues. Furthermore, the researchers even used ChatGPT in a manipulation scenario involving a robot arm where they utilized conversational feedback to teach the AI model how to integrate the initial APIs into more intricate high-level functions, which ChatGPT autonomously coded. By following a curriculum-based approach, the AI model was able to logically connect these acquired abilities to perform tasks like stacking blocks. Additionally, the model showcased a shocking instance of bridging the textual and physical domains when given the task of constructing the Microsoft logo using wooden blocks. It not only retrieved the logo from its internal knowledge base, but also drew the logo as SDG code and utilized the learned skills to identify which existing robot actions could create its physical representation. The AI researchers then assigned ChatGPT to write an algorithm for a drone to achieve a space goal without colliding with obstacles. The model was informed that the drone has a forward-facing distance sensor, and ChatGPT immediately coded the majority of the essential building blocks for the algorithm. While this task requires discussion with the human, they were amazed by ChatGPT's capacity to make specific code enhancements solely based on language feedback. In another shocking instance, the AI researchers aimed to assess ChatGPT's comprehension of the perception action loop, which is crucial for any robotic system. To test this, they instructed the model to navigate an environment and locate a specific object. By providing ChatGPT with object detection and distance functions, they verified that the generated code successfully implemented the loop. To further evaluate its capabilities, the researchers conducted experiments to determine if ChatGPT could make real-time decisions based on sensor feedback without generating a code loop. Surprisingly, they found that by describing each step of the camera image in text, the model was able to control the robot until it found the object. Effective prompt engineering is crucial for the success of language models such as ChatGPT in performing robotics tasks. Unfortunately, prompt engineering is an empirical science, and there is a lack of comprehensive and accessible resources that offer good examples of prompt strategies, as well as bad ones, to help researchers and enthusiasts in the field. To bridge this gap, the researchers have developed PromptCraft, a collaborative open-source platform where individuals can share examples of prompt strategies for various robotics categories. Additionally, the researchers have released all the prompts and conversations used in this study. Besides prompt design, the researchers aim to include multiple robotic simulators and interfaces to enable users to test their ChatGPT-generated algorithms. To begin with, the researchers have also made available an AirSim environment with ChatGPT integration, which anyone can use to explore these concepts. This research focuses on exploring how ChatGPT can think beyond text and instead apply its reasoning abilities to physical world problems to facilitate robotics tasks, with the primary challenge being how to have it consider the laws of physics, the operating environment, and the potential effects of the robot's actions on the world. This will ultimately accelerate the working relationship between people and robots, eliminating the need for complex programming languages and extensive knowledge of robotic systems to automate the entire world. At present, robotics pipelines necessitate an engineer or technically skilled user to translate task requirements into code for the system, which is a slow, expensive, and inefficient process that requires the engineer writing low-level code to correct the robot's behavior. This breakthrough will allow anyone, including non-technical people, to use their voice to program robotics devices to do any task, including humanoids like Tesla's Optimus AI robot, which can now walk short distances by itself, carry an object the size of its own arm, and use basic tools even to fix itself. Despite the progress, Elon Musk emphasized that they are taking things gradually and joked that the robot still can't do parkour, but it employs numerous actuators to help with its movement and balance. In fact, Musk revealed that the Optimus humanoid is constructed with Tesla's custom actuators because nothing in the real world was suitable for the task. Additionally, he claimed that Tesla is the most advanced real-world AI company, and that the same artificial intelligence that powers their autonomous cars will also power the robot's brain. This artificial intelligence not only be used to allow the Optimus to function, but also to allow it to problem-solve and learn new information and skills. Musk also believes that humanoid robots would not be useful if they require programming for every task, so the robots could be trained to perform various roles once they are ready for deployment. But that's not all with this week's breakthroughs in artificial intelligence-powered robotics, as another breakthrough framework for scalable multitask, multi-scene visual imitation learning called CACTI has been released by Meta AI with Columbia University and Carnegie Mellon University. The proposed framework, called CACTI, consists of four stages that handle data collection, data augmentation, visual representation learning, and imitation policy training separately to enable scalability in robot learning. The authors use state-of-the-art generative models as part of the data augmentation stage and pre-trained out-of-domain visual representations to improve training efficiency. The experimental results show the effectiveness of the approach. On a real robot setup, CACTI enables efficient training of a single policy that can perform 10 manipulation tasks involving kitchen objects and is robust to varying layouts of distractors. In a simulated kitchen environment, CACTI trains a single policy to perform 18 semantic tasks across 100 layout variations for each task. The authors plan to release the simulation task benchmark and augmented datasets in both real and simulated environments to facilitate future research. Furthermore, the AI researchers created a workspace featuring 10 tabletop manipulation tasks and a Franka arm. They collected demonstration data from human experts and used an in-painting variation of the stable diffusion model to augment it, resulting in highly realistic objects and scene variations. They trained a single policy capable of completing all 10 tasks with different layouts and distractor objects shuffled from both the training and held-out sets. The in-painting diffusion model's zero-shot generation results were not only visually impressive, but they also played a crucial role in enabling the policy to generalize to previously unseen layouts.